Hello everyone, this is Ale from Yaeltex, and in this video we're gonna take a look at the YURS, the Universal Remote Script for Ableton Live. Let's take a look. At Yaeltex, we offer a framework for you to design your own MIDI controllers. Many users of the community are using Ableton Live to perform and play, and that's why we developed, together with James Westphal, a good friend and an amazing developer, the remote script for Ableton Live. If you ever play with MIDI controllers in Ableton Live, you might know that you have two ways to link your controller to Ableton. One is by MIDI mapping your components to a specific feature in Ableton. And the other one is by using control surface. Those control surface is what we call a remote script. And today we're gonna take a look at the one that we are providing with our controllers, which is a universal remote script that you can customize to your needs. You can think about the remote script as a way to translate MIDI messages into Ableton functions. So the way the YURS works is by expecting some MIDI messages from your MIDI controller, and Ableton already knows what those messages are going to do. For example, if you send on channel 5, note 1 and on, the script will know that that means that it has to play the play on Ableton Live. For example, if you send the note 2 on channel 5, it will mean that you have to stop Ableton Live, and so on and so forth. You can check all the corresponding MIDI messages in our chart that you can find on the link below. And that is the logic behind the script. We can now see all the features of the YURS. And for this example, I'm going to show you the features with the Live 15 and the Tier 4 mix. And also, I wanted to tell you that we also use the Universal Remote Script to develop our own integrations for the Yaeltex series controllers. So let's go and take a look. Let's start with the transport section. Here on the Live 15, we have a full transport section where you have play, stop, rec, overdub, loop, your tap tempo, and your metronome. You also get the ability to control your crossfader, your cue volume, the tempo of your set, and the volume of your return tracks, up to 8. And those will be automatically set when you decide how many sends are you going to have in your set. You can have up to 8 sends per track, yeah, as we can see here. And okay, and you have your volumes also, and all what it comes with it, your mutes, your arms, solos and cues, so the full mixer somehow. You can also control the A and B position for the crossfader. And I think that's it for this part. Let's move to the clip launcher. And for the clip launcher, you can decide the size of the clip launcher. That means how many tracks and how many scenes you're gonna have. In this case, I have a 15x7 clip launcher, which I set up in my script. And the 16th line, I'm using it to trigger scenes, which you can also customize on the script. And also the stop all and the stop the clips on specific tracks too. Another cool thing that we have with the clip launcher is the ability to link two clip launchers together. So in this case, I have the Live 15 and the Tier 4 mix link up together, and we call that linked scripts. And the idea is that you can move both scripts together. So it's kind of having one massive control surface, and you can do it not only with two, but with more control surface. So with more controllers, as you can see, I can move, for example, yeah, I can move also the scripts together from the other controller. And in this case, I'm gonna also take the moment to show you how you can move the scripts with buttons or with the encoders, which is also cool for navigation. One of the latest features we added is the autocolor feature. The autocolor feature will allow you to have your clips colors matching the colors on your controller buttons. So you can easily change the color of your clips and your set, and the controller will reflect that information straight away. Let me show you how that works. So for example, if you select all those clips and you change the color to green, you will see your controller reflecting that change. We offer also a couple of ways to control your devices sitting on your tracks. On the latest update, we updated to the new features in Ableton 11. So now you have the snapshot function and also the possibility to add, to delete, and to randomize those snapshots. And of course, the ability to navigate through the devices that you have on your track, and you get dynamic control of all your macros. Let's move to the other one. For example, now we have control of the second device. So that's a very powerful way to have control on your instruments, effects, MIDI effects, or whatever is sitting on your tracks. Okay, that was an overview of our YURS, the Universal Remote Script from Yaeltex. Again, a big shout out to James, who developed this amazing tool. Please check the description below if you want to know more. And please leave your comments if you want to see updates, if you want to see changes, or if you want to make suggestions. Please let us know. And see you the next time.